I think هذا الذي وقفت عليه. فالأمر قد تواتر، يشهر به أكثر من واحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سورة الرعد، سورة الرعد and the ayah number 29. الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات طوبى لهم وحسن مآب. نعم. Then we will start. كذلك أرسلناك في أمة. So we'll go to 30. 30. Got it? Surah Al-Ra'd. Huh? We didn't do 29. Let's go to 29. الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات طوبى لهم وحسن مآب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising here for those who believe and do a good deed. Always you have these two things. الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات. ليس بأمانيكم ولا أماني أهل الكتاب. You just say, I'm a good Muslim, my father was a good Imam, it doesn't matter. La budda min al imani wal amal. This is why you see all the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yuqrinu al imana bil amal. Yaqul alladhina amanu wa amilu as salihat. This is why the scholars say that iman wahduhu la yakfi. Just to believe and say yes. When you believe and say, yes, I'm a Muslim, you know, and I believe in Islam, but I don't practice that, that doesn't cut it. In Islam, it doesn't. Okay? This is why we see this a lot of ayat. I don't even know how many in the Quran al-Karim. الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات سبحان الله إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات الله قال طوبى لهم يعني فرح لهم وقرة عين طوبى it means a glad tiding and I don't know our people just took this name and they built every in every country there is a city called what طوبى you have طوبى in Guinea Tuba in Mali and a big tuba in Senegal. They have tuba in Gambia. I said tuba in Guinea, tuba in Ivory Coast. Yeah, they have tuba in Ivory Coast. But a big tuba in Senegal. Huh? Yes. They have Safa and Marwa and everything. So, mashallah, you didn't know that? It's so what happened? What happened? They barakallahu fi. What happened? They just tuba means a glad tiding. Okay? Tuba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Lahum qurratu ayn. It's something that will entice your eyes. You see it and you become happy. You see your food, you see your house, mashaAllah. قال وحسن مآب and a good place to go back to which is a your dwelling place قال وحسن مآب قال هو الدار أصلا المآب in Arabic الرجوع مآب آب المآب هو المرجع it means where you're gonna end up It's a good place. فنعم الإيه؟ فنعم المهاد. You see, Allah say that all the time. A lot of way of expressing that what is your good place to end up. He said, كذلك أرسلناك في أمة. قد خلت من قبلها أمم. He said here, I sent you في أمة يعني كما أي كما أرسلنا الأنبياء من قبلك أها أرسلنا إليك في أمة I sent you to, within a nation قد خلت من قبلها أمم but it didn't start with Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم there were nations before him that's why he said قل ما كنت بدعا من الرسل البدعة معنى هنا لست الأول I'm not the first prophet so we were not even the first nation هذا قد خلت من قبلها أمم we have to know that nations had preceded us لتتلو عليهم الذي أوحينا إليك so that you can read for them what I revealed to you which is the Quran al-Karim He's talking about who? He's talking about Quraysh. وَهُمْ يَكْفُرُونَ بِالرَّحْمَانِ They did not believe in this word. The first time, the Arab didn't know Rahman. They didn't know that before. وَلِذَلِكَ يَكْفُرُونَ بِهِ Even Quraysh, when they heard that Prophet Muhammad is talking about Rahman, He said, ما يعبد إلها واحدا يعبد إلهين يعبد الله ويعبد إيه؟ الرحمن. They said, this man said he's worshipping one God, but he's not worshipping one God. He's worshipping what? Two. One of them is Allah, and second one is what? يكفرون بالرحمن. They didn't know رحمن. They didn't know this word. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, This is why he said to Furqan, قل ادعوا الله أو ادعوا الرحمن أيما تدعوا فله الأسماء الحسنى but here he's showing that الرحمن is one of the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى والرحمن على وزن فعلان the وزن in Arabic فعلان بمعنى السعة السعة واسع يعني رحمته ماذا anything that comes على وزن فعلان بمعنى واسع okay ها قال قل هو ربي Allah is my creator لا إله إلا هو we said إله بمعنى إله means what ها there is no ما هو الإله الإله بمعنى المألوح ما هو المألوح ها المعبود There is a Rabb, there is an Ilah. The difference between a Rabb and Ilah is that a Rabb هو الخالق. ومن لوازمه أن يعبد. الإله معنى الإيه؟ اتخذوا من دون الله آلهة. It doesn't have to be something that is true. But as long as they are worshipped, they are called what? Okay? قال عليه توكلت سبحان الله عليه توكلت I depend on him okay and we said always whenever the complement precede the verb that means it's only him just like you say إياك نعبد وإياك in Arabic language you're supposed to say نعبدك But when you precede the compliments, the one that you worship, you put that first, and you put the verb and the subject at the end, that means I am not worshiping anything except what? هنا قال عليه توكلت. عليه توكلت. عليه هنا جار ومجرور في محل نصب مفعول. يعني توكلت عليه عليه توكلت وإليه متاب عليه توكلت وإليه متاب يعني مرجعي غدا سبحان الله يعني it is to him that I am going back سبحان الله قال ولو أن قرآنا سيرت به الجبال أو قطعت به الأرض أو كلم به الموتى بل لله الأمر جميعا. هذا الكلام. The scholars said, you know, when they came and asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وقالوا لن نؤمن لك حتى تفجر لنا من الأرض ينبوعا أو تكون لك جنة من نخيل وتفجر الأنهار خلالها. All of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, even if I do all of that, ولو أن قرآنا سيرت به الجبال. You see, if that happened because of this Quran, سيرت به الجبال. قال look what عبد الجحل said and عبد الله بن أمية. They asked Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن سرك أن نتبعك فسير لنا جبال مكة بالقرآن فاذهبها عنا حتى تنفسح. He said if you want us to believe in you, make a the mountains of Mecca walk. You know, the truth is, شروطٌ, even if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does that, they're not going to believe. This is what he said. وَلَوْ أَنَّ قُرْآنًا سُيِّرَتْ بِهِ الْجِبَالِ. يعني بهذا القرآن, even if I make the mountain walk, أو قُطِعَتْ بِهِ الْأَرْضِ, or we go a lot of miles on earth, أو كل ما بيح الموتى, or because of the Quran, we rise somebody to talk to them. بل لله الأمر جميعا, but everything is referring back to Allah, which means even if I do that, if I Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want them to believe, they're not gonna believe. ولذلك أرجع الأمر إلى نفسي. He referred everything to himself. بل لله الأمر جميعا. أفلم يأس الذين آمنوا. He said, the Muslim, you have to understand. يجب أن تعلم. بمعنى يأس هنا بمعنى أفلم يعلم الذين آمنوا. أن لو يشاء الله لحد الناس. The scholar said, يأس هنا بمعنى أفلم يعلم الذين آمنوا. That the Muslim have to know. The believers have to know. أن لو يشاء الله لحد الناس جميعا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he want, everyone will have been, will be what? Guided. ولا يزال الذين كفروا تصيبهم بما صنعوا قارعة. He said here something very interesting. He said, ولا يزال الذين كفروا تصيبهم بما صنعوا قارعة. Whenever they commit a sin, Allah will يعني تصيبهم داحية. A مصيبة will come and befall them and happen to them. Which is showing us also that committing sins will create, will entail what? A punishment from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. أو تحل قريبا من دارهم. Or it even get close to where they live. حتى و This eye is very scary. حتى يأتي وعد الله. Until the day of judgment comes, which is the وعد الله. He said, إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد. Allah will never breach his a promise. حتى وأتي قال ولا يزال الذين كفروا تصيبهم بما صنعوا قارعة. يعني داء تفجعهم أو مهلكة. I mean, they used to have a lot of problems even before فتح مكة. والعياذ بالله, وعد الله it means فتح مكة. Okay, حتى يأتي وعد الله, until the day that Allah سبحانه وتعالى because Allah سبحانه وتعالى he promised Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that مكة will be what? مكة will be will be open. And the day Makkah was open, I think that was the victory for Islam. It was over. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to kuffar, you're going to have a lot of punishment. Until what? Until the day of a of judgment. As a matter of fact, they said, أي لا يزال الكافرون تصيبهم داحية محلكة من صاعقة كما أصاب أربد ومن قتل أو من أسرى أو جدب أو غير ذلك من العذاب. A lot of مصائب. And if even it's enough for musiba that the big leaders of Quraysh were killed on the battle of what? The battle of what? The first battle of Badr. هذه قارعة. That's a big problem. The people they used to trust, they were killed on that battle. Adi Qari'a. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm going to send you once upon the other until the day Makkah is going to, is going to what? It's going to be open. Hatta tusibahum qari'at aw tahullu qariban min darihim hatta ya'ti wa'adullah. Yani bil fath fath Makkah. Until the day of Mecca, the day Mecca will be open. I think when Mecca was open now, Prophet Muhammad controls Mecca and what? Al-Madina. That's it. That's important. Ah. Qala, وَلَقَدْ اسْتُهُذِئَ بِرُسْلٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. سبحان الله. They used to mock other prophets before you. And we say this many times. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say that? In order to appease him. In order to make him a little bit wild, to comfort him, that this is not you only, but it happened to anybody who's making da'wah. If anything happened to you, don't get mad. Okay? I mean, it's enough for Aisha to be accused of what? Of what? Of adultery. That's serious. Not only wife, a woman, but also the wife of what? A prophet, not only the wife, but the most beloved wife too. This one, for me personally, whatever happened, I say, look what happened to Aisha. You understand? So Allah reminds also His prophet a lot. He said, "Walaqad istuhdiya bi rusulin min qablik, fa amlaytu lil ladhina kafaru." Amlaytu, I gave them time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometime will give people time. ولذلك قال ثم للتراخي after that أخذتهم then I grabbed them. The punishment comes, but sometimes he has his time. They may disobey Allah, just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was patient with Sayyidina Nuh and his what? And his what? That's a big patience. I mean, 950 years. So many years, so many centuries. It got to a point where سبق في علمه أنه لا يؤمن ولا واحد وأوحي إلى نوح أنه لن يؤمن من قومك إلا من قد آمن. Allah knows when it got to a point where he knew that nobody else will believe. He said, no, don't waste time, said Nuh. Time is over. Because I know nobody's going to. But look at the patience of Allah. As long as he knew that one person will believe, he will keep Sayyidina Nuh moving. Yeah. So he's very patient. قَالَ ثُمَّ أَمْلَيْتُ يَعْنِي أَخَّرْتُهُ. ثُمَّ فَكَيْفَ كَانَ. But look, when my punishment came, أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَى كُلِّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ. أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَى أفمن هو قائم على كل نفس بما بما كسبت. Now he's comparing himself here to he's saying, look, how can you worship something different and leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الذي هو قائم على كل نفس بما كسبت. إذا الله سبحانه وتعالى ما هو القيوم؟ ما هي القيومية؟ هو القيام بكل شيء. Remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the one who is responsible for us about what? About everything. But despite that, even what we do is the one who makes, who arranges it for us. على كل نفس بما كسبت. But what happened? وجعلوا لله despite this جعلوا لله شركاء despite that people created what they created associates to Allah سبحانه وتعالى قل وجعلوا لله شركاء قل سموهم. Allah is asking them to name those شركاء if there is any. That's one thing. أم تنبئونه بما لا يعلم في الأرض أم بظاهر من القول. Or you letting Allah سبحانه وتعالى know of what he doesn't know. In all situations this is what? This is impossible. أم تنبئونه بما لا يعلم في الأرض أم بظاهر من القول. سبحان الله. أم تنبئونه بما لا يعلم في الأرض أم بظاهر من القول بل زين للذين كفروا مكرهم وصدوا عن السبيل. ظاهر من القول here they said that was revealed to the prophet. Some scholars said here من ألفاظ الأضداد أم بباطل من القول, that what you are saying is not really the truth. But he said, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying what here? Said, imagine the one who is responsible about everything, but despite that we as humans associated to him. Now, those who whom you have associated, name them, or can you even know, are you telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he doesn't know? All this is impossible. You cannot name them once, to be truth, and also can you let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know what he doesn't know? That is also is impossible. Or what has been revealed to the prophets, he said bal zuyyina lil ladina kafaru makru. Al makru here huwa min ash shaitan. Qala bal zuyyina lil ladina kafaru makruhum, yani zuyyina lahum kufruhum. Their kufr has been made beautiful to them. وَسُدُّوا عَنِ السَّبِيلِ, and they have been deterred from the straight path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a lot of example in one ayah. قَالَ وَمَنْ يُدْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ حَالٍ. طبعا we all know that. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he takes you astray, then there is no way you can be guided. قال لهم عذاب في الحياة الدنيا, they have a punishment in this dunya. ولا عذاب الآخرة, what is their punishment in this dunya? بالقتل والصبي والإسار وغير ذلك من الأسقام والمصائب. A kafir has a lot of punishment. Either sometime in the time of battle they get killed kuffar. Although this is shahada for a Muslim, but it's what? Huh? When they kill kafir in front of you, you feel so... you know that he's killed kafir? And he's killed and he's going where? Huh? Allah, hadi mushkila. This is a big mushkila. Not only is killed, it's like the biggest loser for me in history, it was the, you know, the three people who came in the Battle of Badr. Utbah, this guy, he called himself, his brother, and his son. One family. And they all were killed. And they're all what? And wallahi, if you notice also, on the side of the Muslims, it was also one family, right? Huh? It was Hamza, Ali, and Ubaidat ibn al-Harith. You remember Ubaidat ibn al-Harith? Al-Harith, Harith is one of the uncle of Prophet, just like Abu Talib, just like Hamza. But this guy didn't believe. Yes. It's called Al-Harith ibn Abdul Muttalib. His son, Ubaidat ibn al-Harith, that was the third one. Hamza was able to kill Utbah, and Ali, and Ali killed the other one. I mean, one family, they all killed Kufar. Subhanallah. This is a big loss. It's a very, very big loss. Okay? That's why he said, لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Wallah, they have a punishment in this dunya. وَالْأَسْقَامِ وَالْمَصَائِبِ. And all the calamities that happen to a kafir is considered what? Huh? It's a punishment. But for us, it's ni'mah. If it happened to us and we die, it becomes what? It becomes what? Martyrdom. Even COVID. COVID was ni'mah and niqmah. Right? The Muslims who were killed by COVID, they what? They are what? Shuhada. Al kafir who was killed by COVID is what? A shaheed? But he was killed by COVID. So the Muslims said, no, he's not. It's not shaheed. لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَشَّقٍ. Okay? But the punishment of al-akhirah is even ashaddu. Ashaqqu. Ashaddu is the same thing. Ashaqqu. Ashaddu. Sometimes Arabic language, the only difference is have one letter. Okay? Ashaddu. Ashaqqu. Right? Do and qaf. ولكن كره اللهم بعاثهم فثبتهم. Right? بالطاء. This one فثبتهم the same thing. نفس المعنى. ثبتهم. قال ولعذاب الآخرة أشق وما لهم من الله من ماذا وما لهم من الله من واق. They don't have any المانع هو الواق يقيه. يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم. Something that protects you, that shields you. There is nobody who shields al-kuffar from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون تجري من تحتها الأنهار أكلها دائم وذلها. Subhanallah. And now after he gives, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does that. He talk about Jahannam. Then after that he talk about what? Al-Jannah. مثل الجنة التي, the example of الجنة, التي وعد المتقون, of which the righteous were promised, تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Oh, you know, the rivers are followed beneath. أُكُلُهَا دَائِمُ. The thing that you eat there is what? It's eternal. It does not, doesn't finish. We're not going to say we have a sugar crisis. We have this food is not here. No. أُكُلُهَا دَائِمُ. وَذِلُّهَا. بمعنى وَذِلُّهَا دَائِمُ. The shade is eternal. And al-jannah, the weather is just moderate. It's not too hot, it's not too hot, it's not too cold. قال لا يرون فيها شمسا ولا الزمحرير بمعنى البرد. There is no, because when it's too cold we complain. Right? When it's too hot we, but when it's beautiful, what do we say? You say, MashaAllah. Yes. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes al-jannah what? The weather is always what? It's always nice. Qala, tilka uqba alladhina attaqaw. SubhanAllah. That is the end of those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Habad al-kufar. Wa uqba al-kafirin al-nar. Their end is what? Is jahannam wal-iyazu billah. وَالَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَفْرَحُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ. Those to whom we gave the scripture. Again, it's talking about the Jews and what? Christian. But here, for those only who believed in Allah, they're the one who will be, they will be happy of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi. And he has another ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Same thing, right? وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا مَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيدُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا. Same thing. Because you had some of these people who believe. Not a lot of them. Like who? Who was a Jew and he became a Muslim? Warqat, are you telling me Warqat bin Nawfal, right? Yes. But Warqat, I think he passed away before. Yes, he got the message. And who else? Abdullah ibn Salam, right? Who? Abdullah ibn Salam, right? Al-Muhim, you have some Jews who became a Muslim, and you have some Christian who became what? When they hear what is revealed in the Quran al-Karim and they compare that to what they have in the Torah, they become what? Qala walladhina ataynahumul kitab yafrahuna bima unzila ilayk wa min al-ahzabi al-ahzab huna jama'atu quraish. Okay, and of Quraysh, man yunkiru ba'da, who refuse some of this. Because Al-Ahzab is a group of people. But most of the time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in some of the surahs, He is referring to Quraysh. وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْذَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَمِنَ الْأَحْذَابِ مَنْ يُنْكِرُ بَعْضَهُ. Among those kuffar who deny some of this Some of what? قال ومن أعداء المسلمين ما ينكر بعض Why did he say here بعض? They used to believe in Allah, right? Which means they did not deny everything. They denied some and accepted what? Some. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَاللَّهِ لَيَقُولُونَ Allah. Which means they did not totally deny everything. And I think what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put here was from Balir. قَالَ وَمِنَ الْأَحْذَابِ مَنْ يُنْكِرُ بَعْضُ. They also believed in the Prophet before. If you are saying a kafir, who has a recollection of Sayyidina Ibrahim, they will say that this is true, right? But they believe, they disbelieve in some of the verses of Al-Quran. Okay? لأن فيهم من كان يعترف ببعض الأنبياء وفيهم من كان يعترف بأن الله خالق السماوات والأرض. So it is not everything they disbelieve. No. This is why the scholar said بأننا والكفار متفقون على توحيد الربوبية. Right? We and kuffar, we all believe in the creation of what? Even somebody on the street, yeah, if you go there now and you ask them, do you believe in who created? If it's God, right? No, who do you worship in? That's a different what? That's a different story. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ وَمِنَ الْأَحْذَابِ مَنْ يُنْكِرُ بَعْدَ قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ وَلَا أُشْرِكَ بِهِ سبحان الله. Allah. He said, tell them that I am requested to worship Allah, not associate what? Anything to him. Why is he saying that? Because you have some of the Christians, you have some of the Jews who believe that what? Huh? That Isa is what? The son of Allah. And some of them, of the Jews, believe that Ezra, who is Uzair, ابن الله. Okay? And وهذا شرك. That is what? شرك. Okay? قال وكذلك أنزلناه حكما عربيا. سبحان الله. إليه أدعو. Prophet Muhammad is calling to worship who? يعني أدعو أي أدعو إلى عبادته. إلى عبادة الله أدعو الناس. So this is what I am calling to. This is why Ja'far ibn Abi Talib said, he came when they asked him in Habasha, what is the message of this prophet? He said, he's calling us to wash, to get out of the worshiping of the idols, to worship in what? Of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال وإليه مآب. Again. المآب هو المرجع. It's a place where you remember, we are all going back to who? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال وكذلك أنزلناه حكما عربيا. He said a lot of stuff here. First of all, Al-Quran is hukum. Okay? Al-Quran is sharia because it's hukum. But he said Arabian, which means the Arabic Quran was revealed in the Arabic what? Language. Okay? So nobody can come and tell me that Quran is in another language. No. There is a tafsir Quran in another language. But that is not allowed for you to recite Al Quran in a different language. There's no Quran in any language except what? Qala wa kadhal. وكذلك أنزلناه حكما عربيا يعني بلسان العرب. سبحان الله. Why? Because he revealed that to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Prophet Muhammad was the Arab. Just like he said in Surah Al-A, Surah Ibrahim. وما أرسلنا من رسول إلا بلسان قوم. بلسان قوم. And by the way, Surah Ibrahim is the one that is coming after this. وكذلك أنزلناه حكما عربيا. Now we know why he brought the word Arabic here. He combined a lot of things. Quran حكم was revealed. It was revealed in what? In Arabic. In Arabic language. Okay? That has a lot of meaning today because we have noticed in some countries people have started to pray in a language different way. Especially Mandingos. We are knuckle-headed. We started this problem in West Africa. The Mandingos. Okay? We started learning Alakabong, Tanto Yalaye. Yes. Now, yes, we have, I'm telling you, we have people now in Guinea, in Ivory Coast, in Mali, who prays in what? The Pen Mandingo. Pen Mandingo is very bad. الصلاة باطلة لأنه لم يقرأ القرآن. وكذلك أنزلناه حكما عربيا. أوكي سبحان الله. قال ولو اتبعت أهواءهم. You see, when you follow people's desire بعدما جاءك من العلم. After I give you all this knowledge. Okay. يعني أهواء المشركين في عبادة ما دون الله. After all this, if you follow the kuffar, المشركون, ما لك من الله من ولي ولا. There's nobody to depend on. There's nobody to shield you from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. يعني ليس هناك من ينصرك. الولي هو الناصر. ليس لك ناصر ولا واق يمنعك من عذاب الله. Remember, nobody will help you and nobody will shield you from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is warning Prophet not to follow their desire. Although he's not going to do that, ولكن الخطاب خطاب لرسوله ولأمته. We could be the one who are following the desire of a al-kuffar. Okay? It's why whenever he talks something like this, it doesn't have to be done by a prophet, but it could be done by his ummah. That's why he's warning us. Now, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلًا مِّن قَبْلِكَ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ أَزْوَاجًا وَذُرِّيَّةً وَمَا كَانَ لِرَسُولٍ أَن يَأْتِيَ بِآيَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ لكل أجل كتاب. You know, the kuffar started saying that this prophet is all concerned is what? Is having women. You know, marrying one after the other. Yes, that's how the critic started. Allah showed them that no, that is not an issue. Because every single prophet I sent before him, they used to have what? They used to have wives. As a matter of fact, I don't know any prophet who had only one wife. No, Isa didn't get married, but he's going to get married when he come back. Right?
Yes.
He's going to get married. Sayyidina Isa will get married when he comes back. سيتزوج عيسى. نعم, في الدنيا. Yeah, but what we don't have to understand is not when he comes that we're going to spend 2 or 3 years and we die. It could be maybe a few years before the end. It could be 10, 20 years. And this marriage is a statement. Okay? So to show that he's what? He's what? He's a human being. His coming also is a statement. Why is he, when he comes, he breaks the cross. You know that? And he killed the pig. Why? All of these are statements. These people, we told them how many times don't eat the pig, right? Because it's what? It's haram. They said no. They keep eating it. And they believe in the cross. When he comes and breaks the cross, isn't that a statement? Isn't that a statement? It's a big statement. And this man will come and get married. And subhanAllah, when the time of Salat comes, you see him going where? To the church or the masjid? The masjid. They even say that he will meet Al-Mahdi in the same masjid. And Mahdi will tell him, you lead the Salah. He said, La. Walakin, you lead the Salah. تكرمة الله لهذه الأمة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a respect for us, for this ummah. And Sayyidina Isa will let. SubhanAllah, Isa's coming is very important. Look what he said. قال ويعلمه الكتاب والحكمة. Right? والتوراة و So كتاب والحكمة is what? Quran and Sunnah. Because in the same ayah he said, وَيُعَلِّمُهُ الْكِتَابَ وَ So, وَالتَّوْرَاةَ وَ So the Kitab wal Hikmah here is not Torah wal Injil, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he will teach Sayyidina Isa this book that we have now and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah. Then he will come advocating for this Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi. What a good thing to see, right? MashaAllah. What Tawrat wa Injil. He knows all of this. SubhanAllah. But he said here, the Prophet I sent before, Ja'alna lahum azwaj. I gave them women, wives, wadhurriya and children. See, so that's not a shame for people to say that you have many, but you have what? Many wives. وَمَا كَانَ لِرَسُولٍ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ بِآيَةٍ. There is no prophet who is allowed to bring even one single ayah. And this one will show also that nobody should say that I don't want to get married. Because since the prophet have gotten married, are you better than the prophet? Now you have the priests and the nuns and all of this sitting in the churches and especially the Catholic Church. They don't want to what? Huh? They're not married, but sometimes they're pregnant. Huh? How could that happen? In 1994 or 1996, when we first came here, they had a study, a very stunning study. Stunning. You could not believe. They said the average, because in those days the issue was HIV, right? Remember? They said the average priest, who were affected by HIV is higher than the regular population. How could that be possible? Somebody just worshiping God, praying all the time, then he got what? Huh? He got the virus? Where the virus is coming from? Where the virus is coming from? Now there's something happening in those churches, right? SubhanAllah. Their average is higher than the average of regular people on the street. And the guy said, well, the priest is just like human being. They get affected just like the rest of what? But he's talking about priests who don't have wife and the nuns who don't have what? You know what I'm talking about. SubhanAllah. It doesn't make sense. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said here something very important. قَالَ وَمَا كَانَ لِرَسُولٍ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهَا بِآيَةٍ إِلَّا The Prophet cannot make any verse by himself. Which means that everything you see from the Prophet is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِكُلِّ أَجَلٍ كِتَابٍ قال لكل أمر قضاء الله قضاه الله كتاب عند الله he said لكل أجل كتاب anything that happens you have to know that it was predestined by Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We can also say also anything that is happening there's a time for it, right? لكل أجل كتاب. سبحان الله. قال يمحو الله ما يشاء ويثبت. This is what scholars talk about a lot. ماذا الذي يمحو وماذا الذي يثبت. There are things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase. There are things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will leave. The scholars say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could even, maybe there's something that is supposed to happen to you. You make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take that away from you. This is why Umar ibn Khattab, a lot of sahaba, they used to say, Ya Rab, in kunta qad katabtani min al-ashqiya, famhuha waqtubni mina salihin. Maybe you used to make this dua, Allah, if If you had put me among al-ashqiya, the unlucky, kuffar, that erased my name there and put it what? قال وإن كنت قد كتبتني من الصالحين فأثبته. He said, if my name is recorded among the good now, just keep it what? Keep it there. That's how Umar ibn Khattab and a lot of the Sahaba understood this. المهم كما يقال لا يرد القدر إلا الدعاء. Something could be predestined against you, but because of dua, Allah what? Will take it away. Huh? It could be predestined. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it away from you. Because of what? Because of dua. Just like when he wanted to destroy the people of Sayyidina Yunus, alayhi salatu wa, but he finally what? They were smart. When they saw it, they all ran away and went to the one field, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please. And he forgave them. He forgave all of them. فَآمَنُوا فَمَتَّعْنَاهُمْ إِلَىٰ حِينَ. So some scholars said, يَمْحُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيُثْبِتُ. They said, هُنَاكَ بَعْضُ الْأَلْفَاظِ لَا أَجْرَ فِيهَا وَلَا مَعْصِيَةٌ. There are some few words. It's like when you tell your wife, give me water. Am I going to be sinning by saying that? Huh?
Yes. No.
No.
Yeah, but is that a sin or is that a good deed?
No, it's not a sin, it's a good thing.
Huh?
It's not a sin or a good
thing. It's a good thing, yeah, but it's something that there is no punishment, there is no what?
Reward.
Huh?
No,
there's no reward. It's something, there are a few words like that. Hey, fix this light for us. And this type of word, we have a lot of them in our. Although the malaika will write everything, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no, this one, take this one. What is good for you, yuthbit. And al-ma'asi as a yuthbit. هذا قول من الأقوال. المهم, that we have to know there are things that are, I think the word, the meaning will be a general for all of this. يَمْهُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيُثْبِتْ وَعِنْدَهُ أَهَا أَهَا. The scholars said a lot of stuff on this. They even said if you could have a certain age, and because you are a good person, you have you make qiyamul layl and you have a family tie, you keep it together, Allah extend your what? Your life. The extension of life, that's another issue also. It is really adding to your age or making barakah in your. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala yamhu Allahu ma yasha'u wa yuthbit wa 'indahu aha wa 'indahu ummu aha aha. Ummul kitab huwa la ummul kitab hi qala alladhi la yataghayyar minhu shay. Ha? Al-lawh al-mahfuz. Qad yakun hadha. ولكن لأنه تكمل لهذه الآية قال يمحو الله ما يشاء ويثبت. There are things that are there. There are things that are not there. ولكن هناك أشياء محفوظة لا تتغير في أم الكتاب. باللوح الأيه المحفوظ. These things will never change. Which means Allah سبحانه وتعالى could change some of this stuff because of some reason. Because of your dua, because of your hospitality, because of your relationship with your parent, all of this happens. That's why he said, "Man arada an yubsata lahu fi rizqi, ah, wa yunsa'a lahu fi atharihi, fal yasir rahim." If you want Allah to open up rizq for you, and at the same time extend your life, just keep the family what? Keep the family ties. يمحو الله ما يشاء ويثبت. Just like we said also that the Sahaba used to say, Oh Allah, if you put me among the Salihin, keep my name there. But if you had put me among the unlucky, please take my name there and put me what? If you had put me on the right side, keep me. But if on the left, just take my name there and what? And put it here. Okay? They used to make this dua. Hopefully. قَالَ وَإِمَّا نُرِيَنَّكَ بَعْدَ الَّذِي نَعِدُهُمْ أَوْ نَتَوَفَّيَنَّكَ سبحان الله. You see, this is some of the ayat, the verses that are repeated a lot in the Quran al-Karim, right? He said, I may show you some of the things I promise you that you, they will happen to them. Or you even die, or you what? It happened after you. Some of the victories happened when Prophet Muhammad was what? Was alive. But some of the victories and the destruction of his enemy happened when he was what? فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْبَلَاغُ وَعَلَيْنَا الْحِسَابُ سبحان الله. Remember, you have nothing but to convey the message, and I'm the one who is how has the reckoning. I will make hisab for them. Okay? And he said, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَأَتِ الْأَبْدَ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا. This is one of the verses that really touched my heart. قال أولم يروا أن ننقص الأرض نات الأرض ننقصها من أطرافها. That don't you see that I will take part of the earth. That says taking part of it is when the scholars die. الحكماء والصالحين إذا ماتوا على الأرض ينقصها من أطرافها. سبحان الله. Let's see. قال ننقصها من أطرافها اختلفوا فيه فقالوا طبعا قال عطاء بن رباح قال ذهاب فقهائها وخيار أهلها. هذا نقص لطرف الأرض أو الصالحون. وقال سفيان عن منصور عن مجاهد قال ننقصها من أطرافها موت الفقهاء والعلماء. سبحان الله. The death of the فقهاء and what? سبحان الله. أولم قال سبحان الله. You see all of the time and the scholars are dying after the other. And the time will come that you will have no what? You will have no real what? Scholars. And this is happening. At this time, we have knowledge available everywhere, right? But our knowledge is less than the knowledge of what? Of the what? Of those who preceded us. How is that? Isn't that something? Today, اتفضل.
أشهد
Just give us 5 minutes so we can finish the Ra'at today, huh? Barakallahu fikum, inshallah. And he said, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَأْتِي الْأَرْضَ نَنْقُصْهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا. We said, a lot of scholars said, by the death of the scholars, it's called نَنْقُصْهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا. Just like part of the earth is taken out, is taken away. That's how important the fuqaha and the knowledgeable people are. And he said, Wallahu yahkumu la mu'aqiba li hukmi. Allah is the one who has to make hukum. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made hukum, we don't ask him why. At-ta'aqibu ala shay huwa khalfuhu. Ah. You know, a human being can say this is it, this is the issue, right? Then we say no. We don't agree on that. Why did you do that? Why did you make this? But that's not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا معقب لحكمه لا تعقب عليه بنقص أو تغيير. We don't say no, this is not good. We have to bring something else. No. هذا حكم الله. Okay? That is the difference between حكم الله and حكم البشر. وهو سريع الحساب. It's very, very الانتقام من الكافرين. It's very fast in punishing and rewarding. شريع الحساب. قال وقد مكر الذين من قبله. Even those who were at the time of prophets, before the prophets, they plotted against prophets before. Yeah. Even they plotted to kill some of the what? Prophets. قالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه ثم نقلنا لي ما شهدنا مهلكا. They want him to kill him and deny it. So the attempt to kill a prophet, it didn't start the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال وقد مكر الذين من قبلهم فلله المكر جميعا. But even al-makr, this plot, is within the hand of Allah. If he wanted to happen, it will what? It will happen. Just like it happened to Zakaria and what? And Yahya. Yeah. Subhanallah. And you notice something about makr in al-Quran al-Kareem. It never comes alone. It started with kuffar because it's a bad thing. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond. وَمَكَرُوا مَكْرًا وَمَكَرْنَا مَكْرًا. Never he will say, وَمَكَرَ اللَّهُ. It comes with the makr of al-kuffar. وَمَكَرُوا مَكْرًا وَمَكَرْنَا. Aha. He said, وَقَدْ مَكْرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ فَلِلَّهِ الْمَكْرُ جَمِيعًا يَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُ كُلُّ نَفْسِ. He knows what every soul does. وَسَيَعْلَمُ الْكُفَّارُ لِمَنْ عُقْبَ الدَّارِ. They will know who will have a final ending, which is a warning to al-kuffar, but a glad tidings for a Muslim. ويقول الذين كفروا لست مرسلا. سبحان الله. And al-kuffar said, you are not a messenger. قل كفى بالله شهيدا بيني وبينكم. Said Allah is a witness between you and them. But he says something here very important. وَمَنْ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ الْكِتَابِ وَمَنْ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ. For me, this is not only those who have those Christian and Jews who know the Torah. No, this is for everyone who knows in the Torah that Prophet Muhammad is what? Is what? قَالَ أَوَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُمْ آيَةً أَنْ يَعْلَمَهُ عُلَمَاءُ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. Same thing here. The Mufassirun said, they're talking about Abdullah ibn Salam and all of those who used to be Jews and became Christian. ولكن هذه الآية مكية. هذه السورة مكية. وهؤلاء أسلموا في المدينة. Those we are talking about, they bear Muslim in Medina. So this is even heavier and bigger than some of the Sahaba who used to be Jews and Christian and became Muslims. For me, it's more general. قال ومن عنده علم ومن عنده علم الكتاب. أم الكتاب is different from what? علم الكتاب. Okay? He's talking about those who really know that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is قال أولم يكن لهم آية أن يعلمه علماء أن والسورة الأحقاف قال وشهد شاهد من بني إسرائيل على مثله فآمن واستكبرتم إن الله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين. See, so a lot of these people know that Prophet Muhammad is a messenger, and inshallah by there we'll finish tafsir surah al-Hijr and we'll come to surah Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. Barakallahu fikum wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Okay. Okay, give us 1 minute, inshallah.